Hi there, so now welcome to Bollywood Life.
Namaste. Hi.
Namaste. You've been busy. You've been doing a lot of stuff nowadays. So I have a list of talking points that I need to discuss with you right now. But I want to start by asking you this. How are you holding up now? Tell me what's been happening. I can see the background. It's really lovely. I can see the sitar in the background.
Actually, yeah, you're in my Riyaz books and, you know, all things, I think, stimulating room. There is right. No... I've asked for a cup of Bonvita.
Now we know the secret of your power. Huh? That's Bonvita.
It's Ovaltine, actually, but let's not get into the details. But yeah, in terms of holding up, I think as a creative person, to be honest, it's been a very, very unusual period. And for me, a very welcome period, although I'm constantly conscious of how difficult these times are for the world. Across board, and especially in India, you can never forget that there are so many have-nots, so many people who are underprivileged, so many people having not only a tough time now, but we can foresee that it's going to get really tough on many accounts in right. The coming days. So I think all of us are every day doing our best to keep our spirits high. But at the same time, let me be very honest. I have had one of the most creative phases in the longest time. Been creating a lot of new music, also creating a lot of new IP in terms of content. Because 3 years ago, I set off saying that I don't have to just limit myself to being either a singer or I've never been anyway just a Bollywood singer. I'm fortunate that I have big enough Bollywood hits. But my idea has always been to create a lot of original music of my own, apart from being a storyteller, a social commentator. And to that extent, my biggest passion is the stage. So I'm one of the busiest touring artists and all that has come to a stop. But I cannot tell you, Imran, I think I was on the verge of some kind of a physical breakdown at the time this lockdown happened. Because I had already done some 9 countries in the month of Jan. Mm-hmm. And done some 7 concerts from varied places. You know, I'd gone from Paris to Lucknow, Aligarh, Vishakhapatnam, Jhansi. Then back to Sweden, then... Rotterdam premiere for the film. My film Shut Up Sona premiered, had its international premiere. And I was juggling so many things that I'm here. Yeah. So I just think this whole juggling was getting too much. And when this lockdown came, I've been taking each day at a time. And also, you know, the whole idea of using your own hands suddenly after years of being waited upon. Right. Khud hi khana paka rahe hain, khud hi safai kar rahe hain. And we are fortunate that we have a big home and I have the joys of upstairs, downstairs. Also the pains because I have to clean every corner. I'm an asthmatic. So I have, you know, taken it on in terms of wanting to make each day count, wanting to make each day better than the other, make as much music, make content, be in touch with the band, do collaborations virtually. I set off a virtual series called Guitar Wale Gaane, which has done very well.
That's one of the topics that I want to have a discussion with you about. So let me start with the first thing that I want to discuss with you about is about the live gig session that you've been doing on Facebook, right? Mm-hmm. Because you cannot perform live, so you're doing a Facebook live session. How's that coming up?
There have been 2 things I've been doing. One is I did a fundraiser for Facebook for one of my favorite NGOs, and we raised several lakhs of rupees for the, you know, daily wage earners, and I did it with music, and I was very overwhelmed with the fact that one is the reach of social media is very, in these times you realize it's a very powerful means, because we've been able to convert the love the audience has for be it us or our music into something very specific. We could raise several lakhs of rupees, you know, for this fundraiser that I did. And I have this thing of, I can endlessly chat and sing and do all kinds of crazy things. And I feel very blessed because I'm very comfortable being a performer. So I did a non-stop 2-hour performance where I was talking and singing and I raised funds. Then I did another webinar for the healthcare professionals because they are the ones who need a lot of encouragement and motivation. And again, I was shocked with the numbers. 19,000 professionals actually registered. It was not a question of how many watched. Because the Facebook watch turned out to be a reach of 2 million people, which is, again, unprecedented.
Amazing. That's amazing.
Yeah. But the webinar went crazy. And then I've been doing this guitar wale gaane where I'm featuring some of my favorite guitar players, starting from India, but I'm going to go around the world. So that music has been a whole owning the idea of making it simple, keeping it simple, just a melody which is strong, lyrics which are powerful, and a rendition which is completely unprocessed, unadulterated, because it's live, it's one take. There are a bit of flaws. If you forget one lyric, you know that you can't edit it, you can't retake it.
Yes,
that's been getting so much of love. So I'm at the same time right now, Imran, I'll be honest, we've, you know, every day things are changing dramatically, and as an artist I'm processing things, and I'm like, you know, I am fed up of switching on Facebook and Instagram and finding my fraternity just constantly turning the camera and singing. Ab to koi bhi ga raha hai. And it's okay, aapko agar sukoon mil raha hai to aap gao, lekin apne family ke liye gao, ghar pe gao. Koi bhi besura bhi ga leta hai, and this will, you know, catch me in again on the wrong footing, because people are like, how dare you judge? Truth is, do not undervalue music so much, don't undervalue songs so much, and all my singer friends, let's maintain some standards. Let's not make music so available for free that nobody understands the pain of artists and musicians in these times.
Right.
Because in around the world, for example, in Germany, Angela Merkel declared a fund immediately within 5 days of the lockdown, understanding that the cultural community, the artistic community is going to be hit very badly. Mm-hmm. She declared a fund of 500 million, which is, of course, for a rich country possible. In our country, while we are not expecting anything, right now, we are just worried about the migrant labor, this one, there's always somebody who's lesser fortunate. But right. The truth is, everybody's pain is a valid one, and artists are actually the creative cultural custodians of our society. So It sometimes makes me wonder that, especially folk musicians, I'm fortunate, I'm a mainstream name, I have enough to share, I've been trying to help. But
right.
The number of people in my community, my musicians, my drummer, my guitar player, they're struggling, going to be struggling to pay for rent, their rent in Bombay. And they're right. All like panicking, because for the next year or more, we will not have the stage shows. The industry is completely changed when it comes to musicians. I have seen your site in the past. I know you've been interviewing Sachin Jigar, other musicians. So I don't know whether, you know, people don't want to speak the uncomfortable truth very often in our industry. We don't like to ruffle feathers.
Right.
But the truth is, there are 18 out of 20 releases which are remixes. Very few people are even commissioning original music.
That's
composers
true.
Are going through some of the worst phase. Labels are mostly sticking by the few people they have signed up and they own, and then they're just doing their own manmani, you know. Yeah. So it's a very tough time for the creative community, especially in the mainstream. And also now we have to care more about the folk musicians, the lesser fortunate. Oh my God, maybe I'm talking too much, Imran. You must cut me.
But you're talking to the point, and I'm listening to you, and it's relevant right now, because whatever you're talking, it's making sense.
So
right.
I have to, you know, reach out to anybody who cares. It's not about main koi pravachan dene wali nahi hu. I'm no one to, you know all the answers. But I know this much, that any artistic community and musicians are a very, very special part of any society. And
that's
while we are concerned about, you know, definitely the biggest glaring thing which has caught everybody's eye is the plight of the migrant labor. And it's heart-wrenching, the mistake that has been made, that it was not envisaged, or we didn't. But, you know, to politicize that issue and make it all about them and us and them, it saddens me, because I just feel the poor have a tough time in India, even in good times. You'll see the most desperately sad pictures of the poor in India. And all of us should have a heart and be wanting to help, even in good times. And that's something I remind myself, you know, honestly, it's not that I get it right always, but I'm constantly aware that we live in a place which has such a big haves and have nots ka jo range hai na. At the same time, artists have to do their job. We have to create things of beauty. We have to make music. We have to have joy in our heart to be able to sing. So we can't always be, you know, made to be guilted out. उल्टा हमें ही लोग पूछते हैं, आपने कितना कंट्रीब्यूट किया, आपने कितना कंट्रीब्यूट किया. मैंने कहा मैंने फंडरेजर किया, मैंने पीएमओ के फंड को कंट्रीब्यूट किया, मैंने स्विगी के फंड को कंट्रीब्यूट किया. लेट मी नाउ आस्क यू, व्हाट आर यू गाइस डूइंग फॉर द आर्टिस्ट्स एंड म्यूजिशियंस? आई मीन, हु केयर्स कि म्यूजिक इज फॉर फ्री? एवरीबॉडी डाउनलोड्स ऑल आवर म्यूजिक फॉर फ्री. वी नेवर गेट अ रूपी आउट ऑफ इट. देयर इज नो रॉयल्टी, देयर इज नो कॉपीराइट इन इंडिया व्हेन इट कम्स टू कंपोजर्स एंड राइटर्स. सो दे आर ऑलवेज, यू नो, always like struggling to not ruffle feathers, hoping that they'll get their next commission work. कोई जिंगल मिल गया, एक फिल्म गाना मिल गया, तो सब ऐसे ऐसे रहते हैं. Which is a very sad place to be. A creative community should have the swag of saying, I make beautiful things, I make your life beautiful. Without music, what would your life be? Music sells sabun tel, political campaigns, everything in this country, everything. But it is the most undervalued commodity. You know, it's like taken for granted. And right now, you know what, I'm very grateful for Imran, that you haven't told me, oh, you've come, please sing Ambar Sariya, sing Jia Lagena, sing Naina, sing this. And you know, every channel has been calling me, and it's almost like I have to hold my ground and you know, laugh through it and right. say, "Ki ruko ruko, mujhe bhi baat karne do." Aap waise hi itne negative se ya itne cheezon pe charcha karte ho. Why don't you want to talk about music or what artists are going through or something cultural? There's no place even in good times for any cultural discussion. And now when you call me, you think I'm some bandar who should do a dance for you? Like, aao to aap entertain karo. क्यों भाई? और इतने सारे सिंगर्स जाके वो बंदर नाच कर रहे हैं ना टीवी पे, मुझे लग रहा है भाई क्या है, फ्री का स्ट्रेस बस्टर. स्ट्रेस, आई हैव नो प्रॉब्लम बीइंग अ स्ट्रेस बस्टर, आई एम हैप्पी टू सिंग, बट आल्सो हैव अ रिस्पेक्ट फॉर एन आर्टिस्ट इन टर्म्स ऑफ व्हाट दे हैव टू से एंड व्हाट दे कुड मेक यू थिंक अबाउट. एंड आई जस्ट फील आर्टिस्ट देमसेल्व्स हैव टू होल्ड देयर ग्राउंड. एंड यू नो, इंडिया में तो जो कास्ट सिस्टम रहता है ना, इफ यू गो टू अ अवार्ड सेरेमनी, you will never see a musician actually performing on stage or get a platform. It'll always be an actor doing a lip sync, you know. And pichle purane zamane mein to actors used to work on at least their lip sync. I'll tell you, Imran, right. when you do sahiya tere pyar mein lut gaye hum bazaar, when you do bazaar sahiya, your mouth is supposed to open. Here, you know, for example, I sang some kawali like hip song, was it Jacqueline Fernandez? Or, I think Jacqueline Fernandez. वो सहिया करते वक्त मुंह खोला ही नहीं उसने, ऐसे सहिया करके मुंह बंद रखा है. I'm like, lip sync करना भी एक art है, जो हमारे पिछले generation में actors used to work on it. They used to make sure they know the lyrics by heart, their throat is showing a certain strain when they are singing, and they used to look like they are singing the song. I sang the song for this young, very talented music composer, Vishal Mishra, and this celebrated film called Sand Ki Ankh, and are supposedly most serious actresses, and yet I would like to ask Bhumi and Tapsi, did you not hear the song once before you did a lip sync? Because there is no effort to even lip sync the song in a way ki lage ki wo gana bhi ga rahe hain, kyunki set pe aa gaye aur aise thoda sa muh hila diya aur cut away ho gaye to laga. And actually audiences get it, they are like, ye lag nahi raha hai ki gana ga rahe hain, and you know, the people don't know why it's the case. So somewhere I'm thinking there are so many of these discussions which are important, and it's not necessarily calling out someone or slamming someone, or you know, these negative headlines that come out. Sona Mahapatra slammed someone. No, let's have a discussion about what is valid. True. Because we have wonderful actors amidst us who still care, who will still make the effort ki to sing a song, you have to sing it in a certain way, move your mouth in a certain way. And abhi to wo lip sync ka bhi itna zamana raha nahi, but jab milta hai mauka, because a song makes you larger than life, it makes you like, it's such a blessing to have a beautifully choreographed song filmed on you. But if you don't make an effort, you know, aate jaate chhore kare, how old are you, muh hilao bhai gaate waqt. So anyway, I think there are, you know, even in good times we have lot to talk about. The music landscape is changing. The positive is also staring at me at the face, and I get the blessings of the fact that I've always held my ground in saying I'm very grateful for the right opportunities that come my way in Bollywood. I've had some of the greatest, most interesting solo female hits. But female songs are anyway made very rarely in the industry. It's mostly very, very male dominated in terms of number of songs which even have a female voice. So I haven't felt the sadness of saying that kuch bahut bada mauka chhoot raha hai kyunki itne sare gaane film mein gaati nahi hu, because gaane ladkiyon ke liye kam hi bante hain. Instead, I have been focusing on making a lot of my own original music, and every month I definitely put out one song, one video. Whatever I earned from the live circuit, I invested back in the music, and it has paid me a lot of dividends and has gotten me a lot of love from the audiences, because when I go for a big concert in the heartland and 2 lakh people show up, 1 lakh people show up, it's such a powerful platform to reach out, you know, not only with your music, with your views, what you have to say, how you're engaging with the socio-political scenario of the country. I feel very, very lucky and blessed that we are in times where I don't have to count on just the few gatekeepers who would come in the way of making sure that artists like me would have no work. Because ये तो मुफ्त है, ये opinionated है, और इसका दिमाग है, तो इसको घर पे रखो. Because she is not.
No, but Sona, you have to be, if you're an artist, you have to be inspiring, like you talk, the way you talk about music so passionately. An artist should have that in them. If agar main kuch kar rahi hu, then it should also show, and people should get inspired. You're very inspiring, and I've been following you. And if people are saying move for day, wo hai, let them say that, because you're not that. You hold your ground, right? That's more than enough. Not a lot of people can do that in this industry. And thank you for that. Yeah. I like the way you talk about music so passionately. People should talk about music so passionately. That's a very good thing.
No, so, and I have immense respect for all artists. For example, people think ki, bhai, you have something against actors. No, the actors who are real actors are just as passionate about their craft. They have learned it. They work on the expressions. I can't do what they do. And I don't want to. Because when I'm asked, you know, for the longest number of years, Imran, मुझे सब बोलते थे जब एल्बम रिलीज हुआ, सिंगल रिलीज, आप इतने ग्लैमरस हो, आप सुंदर हो, आप एक्टर क्यों नहीं बन जाते हैं? से क्यों भाई, जो करती हूँ वो कुछ कम है क्या? व्हाट आई डू इज समथिंग आई हैव ड्रीम्ड अबाउट डूइंग ऑल माय लाइफ. इफ द राइट अपॉर्चुनिटी कम्स एंड आई फील एक्साइटेड एंड आई थिंक आई कैन डू जस्टिस टू दैट रोल, व्हाई नॉट, यू नो? बट आई एम नॉट रनिंग आफ्टर एवरी ड्रीम. वी डोंट ऑल हैव टू बिकम समथिंग एल्स, बिकॉज व्हाट आई डू, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, सिंगिंग इन द इंडियन इडियम इज नॉट अ माइनर थिंग. It's not even like anything else in the rest of the world, you know. It's not like that you can write a song with a guitar, you know, and just somehow sing it, sur lage na lage. The kind of Hindustani singing, the tradition or the house that we come from, it takes a lifetime of learning to be able to sing like that. And I'm very, very proud of being part of that tribe. At the same time, I think the world is changing dramatically.
Right.
Young people like you are all over the country, and I meet them in my concerts, and I feel we cannot let the coming generation. My largest audience comes from the age group of 18 to 24, right. And they understand that I don't have to be this. Hey, sir ji, break dijiye. Ha, I don't have to be that person. I have to make sure I back myself, which is why I made my film. So that Shut Up Sona, and people said, why did you produce your own film? You're your own protagonist, and people like to be fakely humble in India. Fake, you know. Wo jo ek Gandhian wo mila rakha hai na ki unko ki fake humble bano to aap mahan kehlao. Main kya bol rahi hu ki aaj ke generation mein let's be very real about these things.
Yes.
You know, if the reality is that ki 100 gaanon mein se 8 gaane mein female voice hota hai. If the reality is that every 3 years you crown a new male superstar in music and otherwise. Why should I keep waiting for those rare opportunities which will come my way? And apart from that, you know, it's not because I wasn't getting to sing much, which is why I made a film. That was just a very small part of it. I feel as an artist, I have so many interests. I paint, I write, I express myself in so many different ways. I'm a storyteller on stage. I have a 3-hour concert where people don't leave. The crowds keep growing. And that's because I'm not only singing songs, I'm giving context, I'm linking it up to various things, and people are like on a journey. And my thing is, I have so many interests, travel, history, culture. Let me put it all together and make a film. And let me not wait for somebody else to bless me with this break. Aur koi banayega. Main hi banaungi. And you know, the blessing has been that we are in such good times. When you take charge of your own destiny and your own narrative, there are rewards, there is a silver lining at the end of it. So despite the fact that I exhausted, wiped out all my savings, and I was very doubtful, ye end mein banega, nahi banega, and in India mein people don't even understand the genre of film. But we managed to, get an international premiere in IFFR Rotterdam, which is one of the top 5 festivals of the country.
Correct, right.
Now it's in Toronto, it went to Sweden, and it's gone to some of the top festivals as an official selection, not as a red carpet selection, where a lot of the publicity that happens here is people wearing gowns and standing in festivals, but it's nothing to do with their film in the festival. It's to do with some endorsement or something else, publicity. But to have made your own film and to have taken it to these beautiful places and to get validation from the world saying that, wow, you are a good storyteller, your story matters, or your music matters. I'm like, okay, thank goodness. If I was counting on just which will be my next Bollywood release, then I would be very depressed during this lockdown. In this lockdown, the one thing I have learned is we have to learn from every adverse situation. And, you know, we are used to just, I am used to the fact that I'm always punched back and I bounce back. And I'm like, okay, the whole world has been punched in its face with this pandemic, you know, there's a health crisis around the world. What can I learn the best from it is what I'm doing every day.
Right.
And I literally need a vacation after this lockdown gets over.
We all need one vacation after this. That's true. That's true. But you know, what's right now, I'm thinking, you know, the world that's going to be a post-lockdown, I think it's going to be a more humble world. People are going to be more appreciative towards each other. They're going to love each other, I guess, because right now people are understanding that we shouldn't take freedom for granted. We shouldn't take the nature for granted, I guess. So I guess the world we go in should be a little considerate.
I love your optimism. But let me also say that it'll be great if that happens, because I'm an eternal optimist. But human beings have also showed time and again, because if you're a history of student and you read enough books, time and again, we forget very quickly. Hum log like, achha, aise hua tha kya? Abhi to sab theek hai. Chalo, maro. Phir se, go back.
Screw Mother Nature. I hope that doesn't happen, yeah.
You know, let's only care about ourselves. Let's not give a damn. But I feel out of 100 people, even if 2 people become more sensitive, I think the world will be a better place. So yeah, I want to be on your side. I want to believe what you're saying. Definitely.
I'm just hoping for it. And it's also like a dream come. Like, it's like I'm dreaming right now. And when once I wake up, everything's going to be all right. I'm just thinking that should happen. But I know it's a reality. It's a harsh reality that we have to go through. But let's hope it's a better world. So let's go on some fun side right now. Okay. So let me have some fun with you. I have some quarantine questions for you. I'm sorry. Let me start with the first question that everyone's asking on the social media. These are youngsters asking such people a question. Okay. The first question I get is like, people are taking a lot of pressure right now of being productive. Okay. So what do you think youngsters should take pressure of being productive at this time? Or just wait for this thing to cool down and they can go out in the world and then start being productive again. What do you think about that?
I'll be very, very honest with you. I have a young team and I've been hiring people in my team for years after years. I don't see them to be very productive. I think this generation has parents who have pampered them so much. Think, aap sab artist ho. Aapko kuch seekhne se pehle hi aap superstar ho. So, yeah. Mujhe nahi pata. My own niece, when I call her, is 16 years old, is waking up every day at 1 o'clock. So, my thing is, I might sound like one headmistress type of teacher type person. But I think if anything, this generation has to figure out that things are not going to come on a platter. It's probably going to be much tougher if they don't really have a sense of purpose. And yes, I agree. वो जो इतने सारे एडल्ट्स बैठ के उनको बोल रहे थे ना, प्रवचन दे रहे थे कि वी गॉट इट राइट एंड वी न्यू ऑल द आंसर्स एंड आप लोग गधे हो, नो दैट्स आल्सो रॉन्ग. देयर आर सो मेनी गधास इन द ओल्डर जनरेशन, व्हिच इज व्हाई द प्लैनेट इज इन दिस करंट प्लेस राइट नाउ. सो आई सॉ दिस वंडरफुल एड्रेस बाय द प्रेस, यू नो, एक्स प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ यूएस मिस्टर ओबामा लास्ट नाइट, व्हिच आई फाउंड ब्यूटीफुल बिकॉज ही वाज एड्रेसिंग द ग्रेजुएटिंग क्लास एंड ही टेल्स द यंगर जनरेशन देयर दैट बी अनअफ्रेड, यू नो, be bekhoff, azad, be free. At the same time, I guess, you know, what I don't remember, but what I felt when I read that, yeah, let's be unafraid, let's tell our younger generations to be unafraid, but let them be much more disciplined, much more focused, and have a much more commitment to the fact that, you know, things like hard work, things like putting, you know, attention to details, putting in the hours every day, they are universal truths. They are universal things which will give us rewards. So that doesn't change because, you know, I think the previous generation had it so tough. I only sit and hypothesize like a artist, you know, thinking that maybe the previous generation had it so tough struggling in India, because India is a struggle all the time, that they decided ki hamare bachchon ko to hum bilkul jo bhi strata mein ho, raja aur raniyon ki tarah treat karenge. We will pamper them so much that they should never feel the strain we went through. But while that is a valid enough drive, the fact that those people do not understand the value of money or the value of discipline or working continuously to, you know, get your returns or to learn something before you can go to the next level is also a scary thing. And it's a discussion around the world about the generation. So I just hope that in these times, when it comes to a certain age group, please push yourself to be more productive. There is no need to chill out that much. There is enough time in the future to chill. And honestly, there's so much of joy in, you know, having a purpose in your life and purpose in your day. Mm-hmm. I wake up every day like a 3-year-old. So excited. So excited. I'm excited about adrak ka chai piyungi. फिर ये बात भी करूंगी बैंड के साथ, वो भी बना दूंगी, गाना भी बना दूंगी, फिर वीडियो भी बना दूंगी, फिर ये भी करूंगी, अगला वीडियो करूं राजस्थान पे करूं, इस पे करूं, लाइक आई एम कॉन्स्टेंटली बजिंग. एंड व्हाइल पीपल से दैट ओ माय गॉड यू आर ओटीटी, आई एम लाइक आई एम हैविंग अ बॉल व्हिच कीप्स मी यंग, आई डोंट हैव एन एज, देयरफॉर यू विल नॉट नो वेयर आई कम फ्रॉम. एंड आई कैन, यू नो, माय बैंड इज 13 यंग पीपल, एवरीबॉडी पॉसिबली मच यंगर देन मी, एंड 2-3 ऑफ देम आर माय एज, बट आई कैन, यू कैन कंबाइन देम ऑल and their energy levels, and then you can put me on one side. And they make fun of me because of that, saying, my God, where is your stamina? We do a show 3 days in a row where we have traveled all night. Yahan pe show, yahan pe sound check, yahan pe press, yahan pe wo. And by the fourth day, and they haven't even done all the stuff that I would have done because I'm the front. So I will have media interactions. I will have this, I'll have that. By the fourth day, I'm back in Bombay and I'm back in my studio saying, kuch naya karte hain. And my whole band would have 4 din ke liye late jayenge because like, बहुत थक गए हैं, हालत खराब हो गई है, टिल भी या उठ के आज मसाज के लिए जाएंगे. एंड आई एम लाइक वाओ, आई विश मे बी आई कम फ्रॉम दिस वेरी हमाल, यू नो, लाइक बैकग्राउंड वेयर आई एम लाइक अनलेस आई एम डूइंग थिंग्स विद माय ओन हैंड्स एंड क्रिएटिंग समथिंग न्यू और थिंकिंग अप ऑफ समथिंग एल्स टू डू इन द फ्यूचर, आई फील लाइक मेरी तो मजाक उड़ती है कि व्हाट डू यू डू जस्ट टू बी इजी एंड टाइम पास. आई हैव नो टाइम पास एंड आई एम प्राउड ऑफ इट. I'm proud of it because, you know, I think I've been so rewarded for being the nutcase that I am. I get so much of love from my audience, despite being the, you know, like, I feel it's such a big joy when you get whatever little success. It may not be, we don't have to compare success. The numbers in the digital world, first of all, become a very fake gauge of success. Nowadays, everybody is worried about kitne numbers aaye. But truth is, in the long run for an artist, your success comes from the fact that has your art been a worthwhile legacy to leave behind? Do people still hear the music you made 10 years ago and feel ki, wow, it's so much fun? Like, Aajave Bolona 10 years ago, arre Rajkumar Rao tha tumhare video mein. People are discovering it now and thinking it's one of the coolest videos. And I'm like, yeah, it is. It is actually one of the coolest videos. And people keep referencing it for their new videos. And I feel, you know, something 10 years ago has not become old-fashioned or purana because it has a certain imagination. It is timeless. The second way an artist can gauge them their success is whether success at what cost? At what cost? If you get it on your own terms, where you get to be yourself, you don't have to be somebody else to make the music that you like or to live the life that you want. If it's uncompromised, my God, there is no bigger gift than that. That's just true. How I feel, you know. And these two things, I mean, every day you wake up and say, okay, I need to leave a worthwhile legacy. It has to make cultural impact. Just following a trend. Abhi chal raha hai rap. तो आप भी रैप कर लो. नहीं भाई, मैंने कभी रैप नहीं किया. एवरी टाइम आई यूज टू बी कॉल्ड, आई वाज वंस कॉल्ड फॉर अ फिल्म, यू नो, रिकॉर्डिंग जॉनी गद्दार मेनी इयर्स अगो, एंड शंकर एहसान लॉय हैड कॉल्ड मी, एंड देयर वाज दिस सॉन्ग ही हार्डकोर सैंग बिकॉज़ आई, दे सेड विल यू रैप, एंड शंकर इज सिंगिंग, एंड आई सेड नो, बट आई एम नॉट अ रैपर, आई हैव अ फ्रेंड कॉल्ड हार्डकोर हु रैप्स वेरी वेल, आई कैन इंट्रोड्यूस यू टू हर, बट द आईडिया ऑफ मी रैपिंग just doesn't make sense because everybody is not supposed to be a rapper and a rapper can't sing like me. You know, Divine is doing such a fantastic job. Like he's right. on fire on stage. And while it's not my genre of music, I can really appreciate it. But I don't want to be him. I can't be him if I want to be. And I'm sure he can't be me. You know,
that's true.
We all are meant to do different things and we are supposed to be comfortable with what we have to offer. And yeah, so, okay, how much did I talk?
No, that's fine, that's fine. Listen, you're being so honest. You know, one of the things that people connect with you, Sona, is like, because you're honest, okay? You're real, you're not faking it, you're there. Whatever you're saying is coming out honestly, it shows in your face. So I'm listening to you and it's a joy for me to listen to you like that, right?
You are a patient, kind listener.
That's a part of my job, yeah. I have to listen because once I start listening to things which are inspiring me as well, because you said a lot of things that is inspiring me right now. I'm going to think about it. So that's really cool. Yeah, that's really cool. So tell me what's next in the pipeline? What's happening next for you?
Loads happening because we made like 4 new songs in the last 10 days. So 2 with Ram, who is in lockdown with me.
Okay.
And 2 with my bandmates. And we are working on this music video called Portraits of Quarantine, which I'm directing. It's a concept which I think is going to be very, very special, you know, because everybody's putting out those collage videos and I'm tired of them. I want to do something within the confines and the restrictions that come with this quarantine, but something which is creative and really special. My film is going to get premiered at the Toronto Hot Dogs and then Sheffield, UK in the next week. So we are waiting for a brand new part of the world to discover the film. We're already getting some really good feedback because a lot of media interview requests have come in. So that makes me feel excited.
Wow.
But what I'm most excited about is getting back on stage in India, because that's where I seek relevance as an artist. I'm not one of those artists who want to be celebrated abroad and feel important here. Mm-hmm. I want to make an impact with my people. I want to leave behind, you know, more beauty in their lives with whatever I do, or more thoughts, more conversations, sometimes, you know, arguments. And my biggest learning, I'll tell you, Imran, in the last 2 weeks has been, I think I've been foolish thinking that I can expect any kind of conversation on a platform like Twitter, which will help us all evolve or learn or be open-minded and hear all sides. Because right now I find people are so inflamed. It's like you choose a side. You either like this side or you like that side. Everything about this side is bad. Everything about this side is wrong or good or vice versa. And I don't see the world like that. I've always seen the world in black and whites. I've always seen terrible people in the best of places and amazing people in the worst of places. People who make a difference because they want to be more human, you know, humanitarian, humane. They want to be empathetic. They want to, you know, so I really want to go on some kind of a social media dieting when it comes to platforms like Twitter to start with. But, you know, it's easier said than done. I also follow a lot of really fascinating intellects there and I get to learn a lot there. So, yeah, I think it's a bunch of things. And this year is going to be like no other year. We are going to come out of this and yet there are going to be no guarantees of any front. And while in a democracy, we have every right and we should exercise that right to protest, to demand for better, to question. I also believe that we need to be examining the truth and, you know, from different point of views. Because just assuming everything is wrong or everything is correct is a very dangerous thing. And I hope in the coming days, you know, that I get to speak to an audience which is more interested in having conversations than just canceling each other. I don't agree with you. You are all terrible. You are, just few weeks ago, I had a shocker. I had people who I would have least expected. I would like, kuch to dimag lagao, go beyond one tweet, see what an artist has done for 10 years to understand what that person stands for. You are an Islamophobe. Why? How? I have lived my life a certain way. Every day I've taken actions which show me for what I am. What is this nonsense of, you know, labeling people and people who think they're the liberals? And I've discovered so many things in the last few weeks sitting at home and creating music and listening into other people saying that, wow, it's time to also probably switch off a bit, you know, and be in your own mind and be in your own thoughts. So that you can come back and contribute more meaningfully than be caught in this thing of defending yourself or justifying something or trying to explain something which is so nonsensical that you shouldn't have to explain it, you know. But these are the realities of our lives. And I think artists need to have a spine, yeah. Artists need to have a voice and, actually show in actions that they stand by what they believe in. Not just with words, doing things, you know. And we need to have people more concerned about artists also. Like, I really wish people understood that music can't be for free. Everything is for free, you know. It takes a lot of effort to create that music. And if we don't value it, all you are going to get is nursery rhymes. And nothing that really enriches your life in the longer run. We are so fortunate. We have a heritage of such a rich length and breadth of culture and musical heritage. you know, beat the whole idea of, I must tell you, Imran, I went to Jhansi Mahotsav just before the lockdown and then Aligarh Mahotsav. And mujhe khabar aaya tha, these are very political things, I don't know if Bollywood life is the right place to say it. Khabar aaya tha ki in UP aap kawali ga nahi sakte. Kyunki kawali to, it is a Muslim, you know, music.
Who says
that? Ho hi nahi sakta. And it was chadhaud, badhaud, you know, you have the left media that went and spread it all around. Saying ki abhi itna inflamed ho gaya hai. कि आप गा ही नहीं सकते। मैंने कहा भाई मैं तो बड़े महोत्सव में जा रही हूँ, I'm going invited by the government, state government there. Not once anybody has called me and told me कि तीन घंटे में आप कवाली तो नहीं कर रहे, आप ये तो नहीं कर रहे। Nobody told me anything. And just when I was thinking maybe they forgot, I went on stage. I did a ode to Nusrat Fateh Ali Khan साहब. I did a 45-minute ode to Kawalis. I got a standing ovation. I went off stage to hug people saying music has no language, music has no boundaries, music has no religion, and I refuse to listen to any of this negative news which tells me that, you know, because logon ko negativity ko badhane chadhane mein hua bhi hoga, kahin ek chote se jagah mein hua hoga ki kawali allow nahi kiya. Does that does not mean that the whole state is against kawalis, and if you spread that news, you are creating a cough, bolte na cough. I just learned this Urdu word, hai na? Kal parson ko some newscaster told me this. You're creating such a negativity and such a anxiety in people's hearts about, is this the world we are living in? Everything is wrong. Everything is so fucked up. And I'm like, no. And it's my job as an artist not only to sing, but to tell you that I went to all these places. I performed Kavalis. I did a 3-hour concert. I got a standing ovation. I had only love come my way. Nobody told me aap nahi ga sakte, aap agle baar nahi aa sakte. Because I was invited within that week to another city in UP, you know, to perform again by the government. So I'm just thinking, there are good things and there are bad things. And it's for us to be able to see all of it, at least for artists. And for us to spread some good news also. We can't only be focusing on the worst stuff that is happening around us.
That's really beautiful. Yeah, that's really true. Artists should have a voice. You're right. And we should have more artists like you who have a voice and who stands for what they believe in. I wish I could see you in person and we can do this in person again. Yeah. Thank you so much for giving me this time. Thank you so much for enlightening me with so many things now. A thing to think about. So next time I'm speaking to an artist, I'm going to talk about the things that you have spoken with me. I'm going to raise such points and we can have a chat like that again. And hopefully have a masterclass with you again once the thing is on and we can have a voice of you talking to youngsters who's doing music. I have a bunch of people who are interested in such things. So let's do that as well. Once everything is over.
I loved it, Imran, and you have a wonderful energy. It was lovely connecting to you.
Thank you so much. And I'll see you in person. It's really great talking to you. Yeah.
I will love to do that too. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Bye.